He's a former roof tiler who got his start in comedy playing the legendary Harold Park Hotel in Sydney every Monday night for 5 years. He now sells out theatres around the world and makes DVDs that hang around on the charts for years. His latest is called A One-Ended Stick. Here's Carl Barron.
Go crazy, go wild, and welcome to the stage, the one and only Carl Barron!
There you go.
Yeah, Brisbane, woo! Woo! We found the dickhead. Didn't take long, did it? 5 seconds, I'm up here.
How often do you put out a DVD? Is this a special occasion or is this a weekly event?
I do it each day. I get a show and I tour it for about 2.5 years. And I've just finished touring the show. And then once it's done, I release it. So every 3 years or so, the last 12.
So it is a special event because it's something fans would look forward to just ahead of Christmas.
Yeah. Yeah, well, once I've performed it, I can't do it anymore, so there's nothing left to do. So I haven't got a show now, so if you've got any jokes up your sleeve, you can slip me in, that'd be great. I appreciate that.
Be back in Mum's lounge room soon. Bloody hot up here. I mean, I know it's not even summer. I know you probably don't think it's hot because the locals never think it's hot, only the visitors think it's... I said to this bloke, I said, mate, it's hot. He went, this isn't hot. Mate, I'm sweating. What's that rain, is it? He said, you haven't seen hot. I said, no one's seen it.
So how did you get your start? What were your first steps?
I just went to a pub in Glebe, try it night.
The Harold Park?
Harold Park, yeah. You know it?
Yes.
You were there?
Love to say I was. Oh. I've been there lots, or I was there lots back in the day.
Every Monday night for 5 years. Roof tiler during the day, then I'd go out there in the afternoon, sit in a cafe and write down some ideas. And week after week, year after year, then I got a TV spot and then more TV spots and then here I am.
Did you ever do, you did Hey Hey quite a bit, did you?
No, I did.
Did you do Hey
Hey? I did it a couple of times.
Yeah, a couple of times. What other TV shows did you do?
Oh, all of them. Where you could do a spot, Rove. A lot on the footy show.
Yeah.
Midday?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I can't remember. I think there's not many places you can do a stand-up spot.
No,
now.
No.
So, yeah, you sort of forget after a while.
In the United States, it's a big tradition that the Tonight shows always have spots for comedians and they nurture them and they bring them up through the ranks. We sort of don't have that, do we, here?
Footy show had it for a while.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm very grateful to footy show because I went on there like 15 times in 4 years, and then that's, you know, people know your face up to them.
I got my license back from the RTA today, my photo license, and I never get a good head. You get it back and you look at it and you think, what happened? What do they do at the RTA before they send them out to you? Do they go, hang on a minute, let's make one of his eyes go that way? They've got some special machine at the RTA that makes you look like an idiot. My picture this year, my cheeks are really sucked in and I'm looking up and my photo looks like this. The worst thing is that's my ID for 3 years. So I go out somewhere, someone goes, you got ID, mate? Well, yeah. Huh? Oh, sorry.
Now, what's the latest DVD called, and explain to me why it has that name?
A One-Ended Stick. I read that expression in a book. It's in a Buddhist book. It's like hen's teeth, you know, looking for something that doesn't exist. So I like things that make, where you can't get your mind around. So, I mean, it doesn't mean anything to me. So
yeah.
You know, people at the shows, they yell out, what's it mean? I said, what do you think it means? And they say, no, what's your answer? And I said, no, that is my answer. What do you think it means? Some blokes go, you can't get a stick with one end, it'd be a really short stick. You know, people try and... I just like the sound of it. One-ended stick. It's just funny. It just sounds funny to me.
That's where one of our Miss Universe entrants come from years ago, Townsville. Oh, I forget her name. The other girl who won it, Jennifer Hawkins, she comes from Newcastle. It's a bit of a theme. The biggest spunk rats we've got come from these real yobbo towns. Townsville, hello. I mean, you go back from Miss Universe, world, you go to the national and the state, and you go back to the regionals, you know, they come from somewhere like Townsville. Here comes Miss Townsville. Accepting the prize with a keg on her shoulder. How are you? Doesn't sound very exotic, Miss Townsville. It's like saying, please welcome to the stage, Miss Gimpy.
Where did you know? When I was really young, at school.
How come?
Well, when I used to get called up in front of the class, and I'd see all the kids looking at me, I just felt, I just knew how to do these little looks. And I mean, at the time, I didn't think, oh, I'm funny. But I knew that thing. I got a funny head. Look at it.
It's not. You're gorgeous.
Thanks.
Healthy, handsome.
Yeah, but I mean, it's a funny head. Well, thank you. Keep talking.
So you were never scared about getting in front of people?
No,
that
I
never
love
intimidated
it.
You.
No,
you
I
loved
love
a crowd
it.
From
yeah.
a young age. But at, you know, I can't imagine there's parents anywhere on the planet who say to their child, please think of being a comedian as a career option. That's something sensible. You know, don't do anything sensible to fall back on or anything. Be a comedian. What was your family's message to you?
Well, they encouraged me to perform.
Oh, there you go.
Not to be
that
a comic.
That disproves that.
No, yeah. Don't ever say that again.
No, okay, got it.
Well, not to become a performer when I left school, but, you know, everyone used to have a few drinks on a Saturday night at my place, and, you know, Mum and Dad used to like to put on a show. They used to dress me up, and they'd add a few drinks, little outfits.
Yeah.
And I'd do a little dance for them.
Uh-huh. Girls' clothes, boys' clothes?
Oh, well, Mum had this famous thing she did for a while. She used to get a lettuce leaf with a bit of string, and they'd take all my clothes and I'd put it down there and I'd do this jungle dance for them.
No,
it's true.
As if I sat there all night and did nothing, you'd be pissed off. I reckon there'd be two art students out there going, that was fantastic. That was cutting edge. Come over here and give it to me, Jeffrey.
How long do you think you can do this for? Is this the 3-year cycle from now until, you know?
You never know. I mean, you never know what could happen, but some days I think, oh, I love performing. Sometimes I think, oh, you know, going on tour and the pressure and all that. Oh, I don't want to do it anymore. Then other days I go, Carl, you'll be on stage when you're 75. So there's a good chance that might happen.
That would be very cool.
Yeah, what it'll look like. This except wrinklier.
Well, we'll check. We'll get a photo of Paul Kelly and we'll have a rough idea at 75. And you think you'll still look like Paul Kelly?
Younger than he is.
Ah.
When you get older, everyone looks the same, like a melted candle.
Yeah, a bit like a melted
Can't
candle.
Can't wait for that. It's already starting to happen. Got to stick a wick in my head.
I bolted to the bathroom, I looked in the mirror and I had an extra eye up there. I still didn't know I was on LSD. I just thought, I found an eyeball. I usually lose shit when I go drinking. I was creeping up to my flatmates and they were all sleeping and I was right close to their head because they all had the extra eye. And I thought the right thing to do was wake them up and tell them. What the fuck you want? Look, don't freak out, don't worry, but you got 3 eyes. I didn't know what to do, so I just took all my clothes off. I ran around the backyard in the rain trying to feel normal. Oh yeah, this is working. I was watching the TV that far away. I thought, my head's gonna explode. I thought, that'll be good, get rid of the eye. All I could think about, I thought, I'm gonna die. I just thought I was gonna die. And what I worried about the most was Mum was gonna have to fly to London and recognise my dead body. She's gonna see the eye and freak out. In the morgue, they pull the blanket on, she goes, oh, no, oh. Worms. Been a great crowd. Thanks for coming out, guys. See you later.